Turning, Dr. Brenda, to you again, you know, you mentioned earlier, and also when we were chatting a few times, you talked about the how video gaming can be used, or games can be used from a treatment perspective and training. Can you elaborate a bit on, you know, how this is going to evolve over the years?
Sure, absolutely. So we started using off-the-shelf video games, like City Driving was one of them, to treat patients with driving phobias, but also to treat people with post-traumatic stress. So this is how you can start to have a continuum of care from the office to the home or to the real life setting. A person that's had a very severe motor vehicle accident and has post-traumatic stress is not ready immediately to get back on the San Diego freeways. They are quite busy at times and you can't control what happens. So if you can teach that person to do diaphragmatic breathing, for instance, so to control their physical reaction to the stress, if you can teach them how to control their thought processes, so what we call automatic thoughts and cognitive reframing, then you put them in that virtual world and you have them practice, gain their self-efficacy, their self-confidence, their self confidence goes up, and then you have them slowly say, okay, get in your car and just drive around the block at your house. Get in your car and drive, you know, 5 minutes to the grocery store on back streets. And so you slowly and systematically get them to realize that they had an accident. It was very traumatic and you need to process those emotions. But then you want to move beyond that and realize that there is always a possibility that that might happen again, but the probability is small. One specific example I'll give on that, and then I'll go to kind of the future of that, is I had a girl who had a very severe motor vehicle accident. She was on her way to college. Her father had taken off work to take her to college in another state. And another teen driver actually came in front of them. She had to stop very quickly. Her SUV rolled over several times and she was upside down hanging from her seatbelt for an hour while the jaws of life got her out of that vehicle. Her father was next to her and he had been killed on impact. So she had to deal with the grief, the guilt of killing her father, which she did not kill her father. But she had to deal with all of that. When I put her into the virtual world, which became very real to her, all she did was put her hands on the steering wheel and cry. She couldn't turn on the gas. She couldn't go forward. But she had wanted, as her goal, it had been to just be able to go to her physical therapy appointments by herself without her mom taking her. But she then began to use driving as her me time. So she drove anytime, anywhere she wanted. She went back to college in another state. She got a job and is doing quite well. And this is a long-term follow-up I've done with her. So it's very powerful. We're also seeing this progress from a disease model to a prevention model. So with mobile apps, with video games, with the internet and telehealth, we're actually seeing people take these tools and we're giving them what I call response ability. So the ability to respond and do self-care and self-help. And this is the wave, I think, that healthcare has been going. It started more in Europe than it did in the US, but we're now realizing here too, it, number one, increases quality of life in individuals. Number two, it lowers healthcare costs. And number three, when we do the integrated care, so putting mental health and physical health together, we see a lowering in, for instance, symptoms of heart disease, symptoms of obesity, symptoms of several diseases, because you have to treat the whole person. So I think this is the exciting thing, is that we can move the needle from disease to prevention with a lot of these tools. And I see that as the wave of the future. Also, with the cost going down, we're going to see more people able to implement the programs.
Great, and obviously we will see more and more hybrid models evolving where we can leverage both of the powers of both of the worlds for the betterment of people.